Welcome to Fish Talk Hunt Radio with John Hennigan, where we're going to cast and blast you right out of this world with some of the best hunting and fishing stories that you can't even imagine.
This is John Hennigan, and we have our host, Frank Shelby. What a pleasure.
Hey,
Frank, you know what? I didn't think I'd even be able to talk to you today, but thank you very much to come and help us out because, man, no one's answering their phone. I don't think anybody's working, that's for sure. And if they are, they don't feel like doing anything. But just in 30 seconds, Frank, tell us about your day yesterday.
I had a great day. I went out to dinner. I'm wearing my, guess what kind of shoes I'm wearing today?
Soft Science.
You're right, because I wore a blister. I don't wear my good shoes very that often.
What do you mean? What do you mean you don't wear good shoes? Those are good shoes. Anyway,
I have
Frank,
alligator shoes.
There you go. Anyway, Frank, such a pleasure. Also, of course, I want to mention our upcoming trip to Alaska, which is almost free, and that is actually Jason said. Jason Grupp is in with us. He said something about, says, most of my people like, you know, fully guided trips. But you get your own boat, you're your own guide. And if you go, you can guide them.
That'd be true.
There you go. But anyway.
Thanks for volunteering me.
Frank will guide them.
And I don't have my Alaska guide license anymore. I dropped that about 8 years.
Well, the problem is with the guide's license, first of all, it costs a lot more, and second of all, it limits what you can catch because a guided trip, you only get one halibut in a slot limit, and you're limited to what you can catch. So you're much better off if you know what you're doing. It's just taking your own covered, you know, 20-foot boat. They're awesome. And come and go as you please. Go out fishing, come in for a hot lunch, go back out again as much as you want.
Yeah. But, I could always just say I was teaching them.
Well, you,
I'm an FF certified instructor.
Yeah, well,
for years.
Well, don't tell anybody that. It'll get you in trouble. Anyway, we're going to take a quick break, and we're going to come back with Jason and Frank, and we got some fun things to talk about, so stay tuned.
The Soft Science footbed absorbs the shock of pounding waves, engine vibration, and even rocky terrain. Soft Science shoes are roomy and relaxed, and they drain and dry quickly. Check out the Soft Science Fin fishing shoes and boots and the Fin H2O for kayaking and canoeing. They're lightweight, slip-resistant, and won't mark your deck. See the new styles for men and women and get your pair on at softscience.com.
It's time for you to take a real fun adventure. Join a hosted fishing adventure to Alaska or Baja with the staff of Fish Talk Radio. Real Fun Adventures can book you on any adventure you desire. Bring your fishing friends or meet new ones. Fish Talk Radio gets the best deals from our sponsors to give you the best possible price. Real Fun Trips are inclusive, easy, no-worry packages to the most popular fish grounds. Trips start around $600. Go to reelfunadventures.com.
If you are still using a plastic hard shell cooler, things have changed for the better. AO coolers are lighter with twice the efficiency of the traditional bulky coolers. AO coolers are the best available soft-sided cooler with 3/4-inch high-density closed cell foam insulation. They will keep ice frozen for 24 hours in hot weather. Easy to carry, less space, it fits product inside for better performance. Go to AOCoolers.com to order or find a retailer. Available at West Marine.
With a long pedigree, the Snowbee brand today offers the very best equipment modern technology can provide. Started in Europe, Snowbee is now providing quality fly fishing gear in the USA. Waders, clothing, rods, reels, fly lines, bags, and innovative new accessories. Enjoy your sport and leisure time more than ever. The affordable value of Snowbee makes it available to everyone. Go to snowbee-usa.com.
Catching shallow, I can catch a deer. Open water or the back of the creek.
time I can.
Welcome back to Fish Talk Hunt Radio with John Hennigan.
This is John Hennigan, and of course we have our host Frank Selby. And first of all, you know, we just recently went through the Thanksgiving, but we can still give thanks. We have a lot to be thankful for, and we'll be talking a little bit about some of that stuff in the program itself. Hey, Frank.
Yes.
Yes. Good for you. Anyway, and we have Jason Grupp. And his partner, which is?
Jackson.
Jackson went out early this morning up Santa Barbara and went surf fishing and caught, what'd you catch?
Perch.
Barred perch?
Yeah.
About how many?
Seven or eight.
Oh. Well, remember, this is a fishing show. You can say 10 or 12.
I think it might have grown already a couple.
Yeah.
He's got you covered already.
Yeah, we stretch it a little.
Actually, what do you keep any of them?
Oh, we have before. Today we didn't because we knew we were coming in here and let them all go. But usually when we do, I want to keep, you know, 10 or 12 of them to make a nice big meal.
Yeah, and what do you do with them?
You know, I like putting them on the Traeger, smoke them, leave those perch nice and whole, make a tinfoil basket so you can dump all the, you know, vegetables in there and potatoes, garlic, butter, season it up. I like putting a little Santa Maria style seasoning on there. And throw that on the Traeger for, you know, 20, 30 minutes.
Oh, yeah.
Not much better than that.
Well, you know, fishing is, well, let's put it this way. When you go fishing and catching, they're not always the same thing. And, you know, a lot of what, you know, we do and Frank does and fly fishing people do is normally catch and release. But, man, fresh fish that you can catch in the morning and you cook it in the afternoon, wow, that's awesome.
Not something you can do with store-bought fish.
No,
no way.
No.
That's the best.
Yeah. Anyway, as you know, Frank, Jason does, he's a ranch manager for a vineyard. And, you know, a friend of him bought this ranch, and he wanted Jason to rent it for him. He says, well, Jason goes, well, I don't know anything about grapes. He goes, well, you're going to learn. Was it 5-6 years ago?
Yep.
And he's learned. Makes an incredible, incredible wines. And these are old vine vineyards, 30 years old. It's just incredible wine. But if you want it, you probably have to join the wine club. But it's not easy because they're very limited production. But, Frank, I'm sure we can find a bottle for you.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, at least one bottle.
Well, that's about what you're going to get. if you come up and visit me, you will. Anyway, let's talk a little bit about Frank. It's Black Friday. You got anything going on at his and her fly shop?
Yes, all the way until Christmas.
Yeah.
Anybody who comes in and spends $25 or more, they get a free ticket. They get an Echo rod.
What?
In the drawing. Also, they get a 3/4 day trip. And everybody that comes in this month, why my journal, Gray's journal I have, ever copy, and I've been giving them away.
Wow. How about loading a reel with 50-pound test mono?
I can do that.
There you go. I'll bet you can.
Yeah, but I've had probably about 60 people so far in putting their names in.
Yeah, that's awesome. And what's the name of your operation?
His and Her Fly Fish.
Well, we know who he is. That's you. Who's her?
Bev. And Gracie and me tie 90% of the fly.
Well, that's the thing about what Frank does. He's world class. I mean, he's probably fished or taught the best out there. And I don't want to say his age, but he's been around and Everybody knows Frank. I can't believe it. But he's a very accomplished fly angler. But
Frank, did you tie up any of the famous turkey flies? I think it's called the gobbler.
I can. I have it.
What? You're making that up, right?
No, there's a fly. It looks just like a turkey.
Oh, come on. It
could be fish like a mouse pattern.
Gracie ties them.
Wow.
And she also ties the sparrows for bass. And she also ties a really great crawdad pattern that does great on stripers or largemouth.
Well, let me understand this. She ties a fly that imitates a sparrow.
Yeah.
Do bass eat sparrows?
So largemouth bass will sit right up on the side of cliffs below sparrow nests and wait for the babies to fall.
Oh, no.
Kaboom.
Oh, no.
You bet. I seen it on Lake Kachuma.
Wow.
I'll bet you've seen that on your pond.
Absolutely. I've seen it on all the lakes. Lake Kachuma especially, they've got some big cliffs out there that drop off into 150 foot of water, and those sparrows and whatnot swallow.
Come out of the nest?
Yeah, they'll put the mud nests on the side of the cliffs, and occasionally those mud nests will fail or a baby will fall out. Those bass sit underneath
there.
Oh,
no.
They know it. They're there.
Oh, no.
Yeah, it's terrible.
Oh, God.
But there are lures and flies that imitate, you know, birds and, you know, even baby ducks.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, no. Come on. Little mother duck with their little chicks behind her, and they'll come up and snack on.
I watched one day 12 ducks. Only 3 was left when I left. And bass took all the others.
An 8-pound bass
dialed in. I'm so sorry for them.
Oh, no. That's terrible, Frank.
Yeah, but it's true.
Anyway, before we get too far along here, Jason, in addition to being a world-class fishing guide and a ranch manager for one of the finest wineries in Santa Barbara, and that says a lot, also has a company called Breakwater Tours.
You bet.
And he arranges trips, and I want to ask him about one of the things he does every year, of course, is Belize. So tell us about Belize.
Yeah, I've been lucky enough to fish the flats down in Belize. We go into the island of San Pedro. It's on Ambergris Cay. So we fly into Belize City, take a puddle jumper out to the island, and I actually line up a speedboat to pick us up from the airport. So we jump on the speedboat, crack some beers, and cruise around the island to the resort, and they drop us off right at the dock of the resort, and we head on in and let the fun begin. And if anybody's ever fished Belize or wants to, it's such an amazing place. We're talking hundreds of miles of water, you know, 3 to 6 feet deep, loaded with giant fish.
Wow.
And talk about a recipe for just fly angling fun. And my last trip, we had a couple of our anglers in my group get grand slams,
which is
permit, bonefish, and tarpon in the same day.
Wow.
And talk about an experience. We got into permit upwards of 25 pounds, tarpon 90 to 120 pounds.
Wow, that's a marlin.
It was amazing. I had one 110-pound tarpon jump our outboard. took the guide with him.
Oh, no, come on, really?
Wrapped him up in my fly line, went over our outboard. He hit the deck because my fly line was wrapped, and then the tarpon was gone.
Oh, my gosh. Yeah, tarpon are, you know, well, they're interesting. Obviously, it's not something you catch and eat, but they're kind of like a marlin because they're strong and they're fast.
They jump
and,
like it.
Yeah, and they are incredible. So, if anybody's interested in getting on that, Jason Grupp with Breakwater Tours.
Yeah, the place I represent, El Pescador, is on my website, and feel free to shoot me an email or give me a call, and I'll help you get out there and fish the flats. It's breakwatertours.com, B-R-E-A-K, watertours.com.
Yeah. And,
hey, Jason.
Yes, sir.
You ever fished the Monkey River down there?
No. What's that?
Try it one time. You'll love it.
All right. Well, we got 30 seconds, so make it quick. The Monkey River? In Belize?
Yeah.
Is it flowing into the salt water?
Yes.
Those tarpon probably stack up right there.
Yeah, I seen one go around the island with Mark Bachman. Thing jumped on the bank, then bounced back in the water. We had to go up and around.
Oh, wow. Okay. Well, we're going to take a break here real quick. And Jason also has got some other trips that, and of course, we'll talk about ours. And Frank, I'm so glad that you're available today. And I hope there's people out there listening. You are listening to Fish Talk Radio or fishhunttalk.com. We'll be right back. Jig me up a waller.
Passionate sports fishermen who value first-class fishing experiences paired with personalized service and amenities, all-inclusive Salmon Falls Fishing Resort on the Inland Passage reinvents the Ketchikan fishing getaway. Guests enjoy exceptional gourmet cuisine, superior fishing excursions, fully guided charter or self-guided in center console boats accommodating three anglers, updated guest rooms and suites, on-site fishing processing to clean, freeze and pack your catch. Rooms range from log cabin rustic to modern. Our 52 rooms offer the ultimate in comfort after a long day of sightseeing, fishing, and exploring Ketchikan. Non-anglers love Salmon Falls, too. Shopping along Creek Street, kayaking, hiking, whale watching, or gathering around our fire pits with a hot beverage, all at prices less than expected. Just pull up Salmon Falls Resort in your search engine.
The East Cape of Baja, Mexico is world famous for sport fishing. Dorado, tuna, wahoo, marlin, sailfish, roosterfish, and pargo. The Van Wormer resorts make dreams come true at a price all can afford. Hotel Palmas de Cortez, Playa del Sol, and Hotel Punta Colorado have the biggest and best sport fishing fleet in all of Mexico. Call toll free to 877-777-TUNA to find out how affordable world-class fishing can be. The finest resorts and the best boats in East Cape. Call 877-777-TUNA.
Vagabundos del Mar Boat and Travel Club has 42 years experience introducing RVers to the joys of Mexico. Specializing in Baja, Vagabundos leads caravans and sponsors fishing tournaments, trailer boat cruises, and weekend getaways in Mexico and the West. Vagabundos Del Mar also saves its 10,000 members tons of money on low-cost auto insurance. Stay up to date on Mexican travel with the printed newsletter online at vagabundos.com or call 800-474-BAJA.
With a long pedigree, the Snowbee brand today offers the very best equipment modern technology can provide. Started in Europe, Snowbee is now providing quality fly fishing gear in the USA. Waders, clothing, rods, reels, fly lines, bags, and innovative new accessories. Enjoy your sport and leisure time more than ever. The affordable value of Snowbee makes it available to everyone. Go to snowbee-usa.com.
A full-service fly shop, His and Her Fly Fishing, offers FFI-certified international fly fishing instructor and guide service with Frank Selby. Listen to Frank as host of FishHuntTalkRadio.com or listen live Saturdays at 9 a.m. Pacific Time on SiriusXM Radio Channel 211. Custom flies are handmade to your order in-house in Newport Beach. Fishing in Mexico, Belize, Florida, or the Rockies, Frank and the staff will deliver exactly what you need. Flies and gear. Google His and Her Fly Fishing.
Welcome back to Fish Talk Hunt Radio with John Hennigan.
Oh, this is John Hennigan, and of course we have our host Frank Selby, and we have a very special guest, Jason Grupp, and his sidekick, which is?
Jackson.
Jackson just turned 12 years old, and Jason and Jackson went to... came down and to get on the show and decided to go out fishing for a couple hours and just went down to the surf and caught some barred perch and came in ready to go. Anyway, here we are. Frank, I was talking to Jason earlier about Belize, and I asked him about the cuisine. Can you talk a little bit about what we talked about, the lobster?
Yeah, last time we came in off the water, 14 hours throwing fly for giant tarpon. You talk about working up an appetite. Came into the resort to a platter of 25 lobsters.
A table.
For, not eight, a platter. For eight guys. And we didn't leave one of them, I guarantee you.
Wow.
Not so bad, you know, yeah. And they do all the authentic rice with it and just amazing Belizean cuisine.
Yeah. Well, I was curious about what Belizean cuisine is, so I guess, you know, if you live on a little island in Belize, then it probably has something that comes from the sea.
Yeah, lots of really good shellfish and some different, you know, whatever's running. They'll keep a fish occasionally and mm-hmm. cook that up at the resort.
Right. Bet. Well, before we left, you're talking about the you're in Belize in the tarpon that jumped over the boat and almost took the captain with him.
It did, yeah. He had to grab onto his you know, push-pull deck so he wouldn't go into the water as much.
Oh, I was going to ask you, what method? You take a little boat, a stand-up paddleboard, or you walk out in the surf, or how do you fish there?
No, they have these beautiful center console flats boats is mm-hmm. what they call them, similar to ones you've seen in Florida and, you know, anywhere that has flats. And the pulling deck is on the back, you know, just above the outboard. So the angler's up on the front to fly cast because it's primarily fly fishing down there. There, you know, you can go out with spinning gear, but you'll have more success for permit, tarpon, bones, snook, you know, using a fly rod. So you're up on the front. The captain's on the back pulling. And it's an amazing experience. Hundreds of miles, 3 to 6 feet deep water,
wow.
Just giant, giant fish.
Wow. Well, do you have a trip lined up for 2020?
Yeah, I have a few groups going. And if anybody wants to go down to El Pescador, that's the resort we use, which is on the island of San Pedro. We fly into Belize City, jump on a puddle jumper out to the island, and then I have a speedboat pick us up and buzz us around the island to the resort, which that's worth the price of admission right there.
Yeah.
And next day we go out bright and early and fish the flats, and the guides are just amazing. And one really neat part about Belize is they're all English speaking down there, so there's no language barriers, and everybody's just super friendly, and the islands are very, very safe place to go. And
oh, yeah.
An amazing experience.
Well, if you're a bad guy, you can't get away, right?
No, that's right. Yeah.
But anyway, Frank, you have any quick comments on that?
I loved it down there. Did you ever see an iguana run up somebody?
Not up somebody, but we saw plenty of them. We had a crocodile walking behind
now.
The resort.
But Joe Fisher, there was five of us. We were out fishing the flat, and this iguana ran up him. And
ran up him?
And all the way up to his head and put claw marks in his head.
Oh, my gosh.
And somebody says, let me take a picture. I don't want to say what he was saying.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, they're popular with the tourists, but I never heard him crawling up somebody. That doesn't sound like something I'd want.
We spoofed it.
Yeah.
And it's just the highest thing we can see.
Hey, Frank, while we're talking about breakwater tours, have you ever fished El Salto?
No.
Well, let's have Jason tell us about it.
Lake El Salto is one of the best bass fishing lakes in the world, hands down. And I can attest to that. I've been going there every year for 20 years.
Mm-hmm.
And we average, you know, 80 to 120 bass a day. And we're
Whoa.
Not talking about dinks. We're talking about 5, 6, 7, 8
Whoa.
Pound fish. And, you know, one of the main goals that every client can have going into that lake is to catch a double-digit bass.
Wow.
And it's absolutely realistic to do that down there. They commercially fish this lake for tilapia.
Well, that's said. It's a tilapia lake, and bass like tilapia.
They do. So they're just loading these bass up with tilapia, and they grow huge. And they're eating iguanas, too. Mentioned iguanas. I've seen it happen.
Oh, no. Hey, Frank, do you know how to tie an iguana? Do you tie iguana flies?
No.
You better learn.
I've tied some lizards, but
lizards,
never
yeah.
iguanas.
Wow.
You ever get any of them big catfish on the fly?
Not at El Salto, but Lake Kachuma, when I've been out there guiding, we've caught plenty of catfish on baitfish patterns.
Yeah.
You bet.
But
so anyways, Lake El Salto, 24,000 acre lake. It's huge.
Wow.
And we fly into Mazatlan, and it's about an hour and a half run to the lake, real close. It's easy. The resort does all the driving. They pick you up. Literally, you step off the airplane, and there's a representative there holding your hand, grabbing your bags and handing you a cold beer. And we head out to the lake, where the package that Breakwater Tours offers is a 3.5 day fishing package. Four nights, and that's all your alcohol, all your foods included, under $2,000.
Whoa!
Yep, it's not that expensive. And to go fish the best bass fishing lake in the world.
Wow.
It's amazing. So we go down there every year. If anybody wants to go experience this, just shoot me an email or give me a call, and I'd be happy to set you up with all the right gear and how to do it. Best bass lake in the world. Hit me up on breakwatertours.com.
Yeah. Man, I didn't. That's cheap.
It is. It's not that bad. Yeah. That includes all your food, all your alcohol. You can drink as much as you want. And they have those little 8-ounce Pacificos down there. We love them. They stay cold.
Yeah. You only see them down there. They're awesome. The first time I ever had, I think, a Corona was out in a boat, and they served these 8-ounce Coronas, ice cold. And, you know, the thing is, at a 12-ounce, you hold it in your hand for a little while, and it warms up. But those small ones, man, they stay cold, and then you just grab another one.
You take a quick break midday because it gets so hot.
Yeah.
Go in, have a nice big lunch, and then go back out with your guide and go catch another 60 bass.
Wow. This doesn't – Frank, does this sound real? This is a fishing,
yeah.
Is this a fishing
yeah,
story?
Yeah, Carrera's the same way.
You know, I remember old friend Grizz used to go down to El Salto and talk about a person that's got a lot of stories from that place. He's got them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. We still have him as an introduction to keep him around, but that was unfortunate. I just hate it when all these people die off on me because, you know, the problem is, Frank, is you're an old friend, so don't die. But, but you know,
hey,
you can always.
I was taught very young. The good die young, the bad die very, very, very old. And my family is not one of us. There's men that's not lived under 100, over 100.
Wow.
Except for a war or accident.
Yeah. Well, yeah, don't jump in front of a bus. But, the thing is that it's not that difficult to make friends, but there's no way you can make new old friends.
Yeah,
that's special. That anyway, let's not get off on that. But while we are, you know, we're just getting through a Thanksgiving, and we got a lot to be thankful for, especially Jason. Man, all he does is grow grapes, run around the vineyard, uses trout pond, takes people fishing, and, you know, he knows how to cook and eat, too.
Yeah, my 12-year-old son outfished me this morning.
That's great. But anyway, let's talk about El Salto. What's in the trip? Where do you go?
Yeah, so fly into Mazatlan, get picked up, head out to the resort.
What's the resort?
Angler's Inn is who we use, and it's Billy Chapman. He was the originator. He helped stock that lake with bass. So he's got just a beautiful resort right on the edge of the water, top-notch boats. And service is their focus, which is great. And you've never been to a resort that takes as good a care of their clients as this place does. You never carry a bag. You're never without a beer. And, it's not that expensive and some of the best fishing you can do.
Not that expensive. It's almost free. You say, do the whole thing for less than $2,000?
Yeah, for the resort fees. And then the airfare, let's say, from California is only, $500 to $800, depending on the time of year. So you can do this trip for $3,000 to the best bass fishing lake in the world.
All included.
All included.
Wow.
You bet. So I've been helping my clients get down there for 20 years. My services are free. Give me a call, and I can help you get down there and get you some gear and go fish the best bass lake in the world.
Wow. Well, we've got a big audience out there, so I'm sure they'll be hearing some people will be talking to you.
I hope so.
Yeah. And what time of the year do you go?
You know, you can fish it any time of the year. They do close down in the summer months for a little bit because it's just too dark.
August and September.
Right, right. But spring, fall, even now, I head on down there. It's amazing fishing. It's,
where I am, Southern California, is friggin' cold. I would like to be in Mexico. All right. Okay. Anyway, Frank, coming up next, we've got a friend of yours that we're going to talk to, and I'm interested in seeing who that is, but we're going to find out. But Frank, thank you so much, and his and hers fly shop, and you don't have to be in Southern California to buy from you, right?
No, we ship all over.
And by the way, there's, you know, he does, if you're going to Belize or to El Salto and you want some flies, he knows what works everywhere, and he'll custom make it for you. So anyway, we're going to have to take off, Frank. We're going to be back in a couple of minutes, so don't go away.
Oh, Lord. Honey, that sounds like rain. Hurry up, woman. Get the youngest. Let's go.
The road stretches for miles in front of you. And with the Ram 1500, you'll be able to reach mile after open mile. It gets a best-in-class 25 miles per gallon highway, so your destination won't just be determined by your gas gauge, but by your gauge for achievement. And the Ram 1500 is the first-ever back-to-back Motor Trend Truck of the Year. Guts. Glory. Ram. See your local Ram dealer today for great deals. EPA estimated 25 mpg highway based on V6 4x2.
A full-service fly shop, His and Her Fly Fishing, offers FFI certified international fly fishing instructor and guide service with Frank Selby. Listen to Frank as host of FishHuntTalkRadio.com or listen live Saturdays at 9 a.m. Pacific Time on Sirius XM Radio Channel 211. Custom flies are handmade to your order in-house in Newport Beach. Fishing in Mexico, Belize, Florida, or the Rockies, Frank and the staff will deliver exactly what you need. Flies and gear. Google His and Her Fly Fishing.
A few years ago, a sailor set out to design a boat shoe that was comfortable and stable, non-skid, and wouldn't mark the decks. Today, these incredibly comfortable shoes are worn by anglers, boaters, professional guides, and charter captains. Go to softscience.com to see more. Soft Science shoes and boots are lightweight and shock-absorbent with just the right level of support. Several styles come in all sizes. Enjoy the Soft Science shoe in the water and out. Check them out at softscience.com.
Alaskan RV Butler. Guiding, fishing, hiking, sightseeing, adventure. The Alaskan RV Butler. Like a cruise on wheels in the comfort of an RV, view the wonders of Alaskan interior streams, ocean, and wildlife. Or fish for the big one, all while pampered by Mike, the Alaskan RV Butler. Mike's inclusive tours serve butter-drenched shellfish and mouth-watering steaks. Mike is your personal chef, chauffeur, guide, and planner. And for the real Alaska, contact MikeRVButler@gmail.com. That's MikeRVButler@gmail.com.
It's time for you to take a real fun adventure. Join a hosted fishing adventure to Alaska or Baja with the staff of Fish Talk Radio. Real Fun Adventures can book you on any adventure you desire. Bring your fishing friends or meet new ones. Fish Talk Radio gets the best deals from our sponsors to give you the best possible price. Real Fun Trips are inclusive, easy, no-worry packages to the most popular fish grounds. Trips start around $600. Go to reelfunadventures.com.
Welcome back to Fish Talk Hunt Radio with John Hennigan.
This is John Hennigan and our host Frank Selby, and we're just sitting around here talking about things and having fun. We have Jason Grupp in, who's a world-class guide and wine maker, grower, and takes tours pretty much everywhere. And, of course, Frank Selby, which I'd like to have Frank introduce Tony. Would you mind, Frank?
Not at all. I've known Tony for a lot of years. We won't say how many years. Then I worked for his son-in-law. I brought groups up there for years, over 20.
All right. Well, where is that?
And it is the best place on the river.
All right. Well, where are we talking about? Are we talking about South America?
The Alaska River in Alaska.
Wow.
Tony, well, tell them a little bit about it and how to get in touch with you.
Well, it's located where the Aleutian Islands come into the main body of Alaska and on the northern side of that juncture. So it's in Bristol Bay, which is kind of like where all the red sockeye are, about 40 to 50 million a year are caught out of there. So it's a bunch of fish. And they come in at about a three-week period. So when they come, they come. We at our river have the last from the sockeye for Bristol Bay. So that's fortunate because we're getting them towards, ours come in towards the end when the commercial fishing is starting to lighten up. So that's how we manage to maintain pretty good numbers of
them.
Yeah.
No, that's incredible fishing. A good friend of mine, she's a customer service supervisor for Alaska, and they sent her up there during the time of the year to help out. And, she's not petite, but, man, everybody's loading those 40-pound boxes that are stacked up everywhere. There's a lot of fish come out of there, in just a couple of weeks. So, but it's, of course, the kings are also very popular up there. But
right.
Sockeyes are, I like the sockeye. They're, it's obviously it's red meat, and it's got more flavor than the other salmons.
Right. Kings and sockeye are very, very close in that respect. They're very close. They're red. They're definitely with the desirable oils and really good tasting. And
mm-hmm.
and we're the tidal waters of the river, so we get them day one, which puts them in really good shape. Full of fight and fresh, so really good when we clean them out.
Mm.
By the way, those are 50-pound boxes of fish, not 40.
Oh.
Everybody takes home a 50-pound.
Yeah.
So you're
saying... part of the deal is we keep them, throw them in a box right away, keep them cold, fillet them, flash freeze them, put out a wax box for everybody to take them home in this airline approved, so you can take them home as luggage. So, yeah, a lot of people end up taking a lot of fish home.
Yeah, like three, four, five boxes.
Not so bad.
Well, that number, that's for like out of the Anchorage area. Because we're wilderness, we use float planes, we limit people to one 50-pound box.
Yeah.
And which is
I think that's great.
That's a lot.
So you're saying you get them on day one. Does the quality of the meat go down as they're coming up the river? How does that work?
Oh, totally. Totally. So as they progress up, day two, three, day two, three, that's fine. But when you start getting a fish in the river, now he stopped eating when he got in the river.
Yeah.
He starts living on himself. He starts changing.
Depleting.
As he or she gets ready to
spawn.
To go up there and spawn. So they undergo tremendous changes. So a lot of the sockeye you see pictures of are like the green head, the red body. We get them with silver bodies and no hooks or distortion.
Mm-hmm.
Later, they go through that transition, and there's no way you want to eat one of those.
Yeah.
Now they're ready for spawning.
Yeah.
Although the fish eggs are good, but not the fish.
Oh, that's interesting. You mentioned fish eggs. We haven't talked about that before. What do you do with them?
We end up tossing the river to our resident trout.
Trophy rainbows.
One of the things, too, about fish eggs is when they're not mature yet, they're not ready. Well, they're in these sacks, and they're really hard to get out.
Yeah.
You really got to know what you're doing. But later on, when they're ready to just squirt out of the fish and come out of the reed, then they're fairly easy to get out. And so, like the Japanese, when they're looking at what they want to buy for eggs, they want to get those mature eggs.
Yeah.
They don't want the immature ones like we have when the fish arrive at
us. You just use them to sprinkle on things, or what?
Well, we come to the river, and then we have a lot of trout.
we give
them names because they're 10-pounders.
Well, let's talk about trout.
Well, yeah, but that's like a guilty pleasure because we have to catch and release completely.
Oh.
And, you throw out some eggs, you throw in a hook, and by God, you got a 10-pound wild trout.
Wow.
But you're going to let it go, and, okay. But it's still fun.
Oh, you mean by law?
Yeah, he used to chew me out for chumming.
Well, we're kind of into it now. It's funny, we used to do killing trout, but the last 15 years we've done catch and release, and now we got a lot of really good trout hanging in the lower river.
Now, is that
so? That's a nice thing.
Is that by regulation or choice?
Right,
we lost you. Where are you at, Mark?
Because we don't want to kill our trout.
There we go. Okay, all right. So it's your own choice.
It was a choice of the lodge owners petition Fish and Game to make it regulations.
Okay.
How are you guys catching those rainbows? Using fly rod or traditional gear?
Absolutely.
Good.
Absolutely.
Good.
Just for the fun of playing them.
Hey, Frank, I have a question for you.
Sure.
If you are a purist, you could not put a fish egg on a hook and throw it out, could you?
No way.
So
you can make the egg pattern.
Yeah.
And it works just as good.
Yeah. Yeah.
But we're a sports fishing river, and therefore no live, no scent, just artificial.
Oh.
We're a sports fishing river.
Yeah.
So that's why you can't do that.
Yeah. But you can throw some eggs in the water, and then they're looking for the flies. Yeah.
I don't think if the Fish and Game guy was standing next to me, I'd be doing that.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's chumming. And in fresh water, that's not good.
Yeah. But, you know, how do I justify it in my mind? Because it's kind of fun, and we release them all.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, you know, I'm curious. I've never caught a trout, I think, over 3 pounds. How do they fight?
Extremely well. Extremely well.
Excellent. Tail walker.
Oh.
Can't compare to them 10 to 12 pounds.
Yeah.
Oh,
well, Jason's
yeah,
got...
these are wild salmon. Yeah. I mean, excuse me, and wild trout. These are wild fish. So they fight like the jiggers. They're definitely going to take you into your backing.
Mm-hmm. Well, let's find out a little bit about what you're doing in your lodge and give us a typical, somebody wants to come up and visit you. What are they going to expect? What are they going to get? And range and the price.
Okay, well, things have changed a bit over the years as airlines become a little bit nasty about baggage. So I now provide all the gear necessary. You bring what you want, and I'll have the rest of it. And I'm talking waders, boots, rods, reels, lines. You can come up with just your raincoat and a good hat and gloves, and we can provide the rest for you.
Mm-hmm. And tell us about
a good bottle of scotch.
Yeah.
Bring your own booze, please.
Yeah. Well, tell us about the lodge and the accommodations.
It's a single building. We have, I can hold up to, I hold up to 20 people. I've got like 26 beds. But we have 7 rooms that have single beds. We have 5 rooms that have 3 beds each. And I try to spread everybody out. Some groups like to be together, others like to spread out.
Mm-hmm.
What is set and what really is my capacity is it's 2 people per boat with a guide. And you can fish basically 9 hours a day in that. And then we also fish in the evening, so you can fish, and a lot do like morning and evening and take off the afternoon.
Yeah,
and then we can make arrangements more time if you want to. Yeah, we have, 3 meals a day.
We got one more.
And we kind of run that on a clock just so everybody knows when it's going to happen. And it's served buffet style. And you just take as much as you want.
And there's always a little bit of smoked fish there downstairs, no matter what time you come. And there is always some kind of cookies or something. I miss my pastry girl.
Well, we have a pastry girl back.
I
have a real chef and
you.
A real pastry cook. Okay, go, Frank.
Okay, well, we've only got...
Years ago, I brought that a pink rod, pink carrying case, and I'm in the airport,
gosh.
And they gave me a bad time. She still uses that, or she was a teacher part of the year. You remember who I'm talking about?
Not really.
Okay, well, Frank.
We do have staff turnover. Sorry,
Frank. We've only got about a minute left.
Okay.
Let's kind of go over the lodge itself. I assume it's all inclusive.
Oh, right. It's all inclusive, and you asked the price, and I didn't respond. So it's a base price of $725 plus $725 a day. We're kind of unique in so much as we'll let you come and go on the day you want and come as long as you want. Mm-hmm. But to do the quick math, for instance, if you came 7 days, that would be $5,800. If you came like
3 days, four nights. Yeah.
765. And no, oh, it's full days and nights this are the same.
Mm-hmm.
So 7 nights.
Tell them how to get
7 days of fishing, 7 days.
Okay, we got to go. How do we get in touch with you?
808-227-9301.
All right.
And of course, I have a website, blacknacklodge.com.
Make it fast. What's your website?
Everything is on there.
5 seconds. What's your website?
Blacknacklodge.com.
Blacknacklodge.com.
A-L-A-G-N-A-K Lodge.
All right, perfect. All right, we got to go to a break. Thank you very much. And we'll be right back with you.
Taking them up.
The Soft Science footbed absorbs the shock of pounding waves, engine vibration, and even rocky terrain. Soft Science shoes are roomy and relaxed, and they drain and dry quickly. Check out the Soft Science Fin fishing shoes and boots and the Fin H2O for kayaking and canoeing. They're lightweight, slip-resistant, and won't mark your deck. See the new styles for men and women and get your pair on at softscience.com. Used by fishermen who know where to get the best fishing gear around, AFTCO makes the highest quality fishing rod components worldwide. If it says AFTCO, you know you have a quality rod. Guy Harvey Clothing, the best outdoor clothing line anywhere, is also available through AFTCO. Longest lasting, functional, and best looking clothing you'll be proud to wear. Only the very best materials and workmanship. As soon as you put it on, you'll know the difference. Look for AFTCO at quality retailers or go to AFTCO.com.
Fish on!
That's a big one.
For passionate sports fishermen who value first-class fishing experiences paired with personalized service and amenities, all-inclusive Salmon Falls Fishing Resort on the Inland Passage reinvents the Ketchikan fishing getaway. Guests enjoy exceptional gourmet cuisine, superior fishing excursions, fully guided charter or self-guided in center console boats accommodating three anglers, updated guest rooms and suites, on-site fishing processing to clean, freeze, and pack your catch. Rooms range from log cabin rustic to modern. Our 52 rooms offer the ultimate in comfort after a long day of sightseeing, fishing, and exploring Ketchikan. Non-anglers love Salmon Falls, too. Shopping along Creek Street, kayaking, hiking, whale watching, or gathering around our fire pits with a hot beverage, all at prices less than expected. Just pull up Salmon Falls Resort in your search engine.
Every time I can, I get to be a fisherman. Yeah, I'm a fisherman.
Welcome back to Fish Talk Hunt Radio with John Hennigan.
Yeah, and this is John Hennigan, our host, Frank Shelby.
I'm here.
Hey, Frank, you know what? Let's kind of tie things together here a little bit. First of all, for selfish reasons, we want to talk about our trip to Ketchikan this year, which is an incredible. Lodge had a few extra days in the middle that wasn't booked, and they're pretty much booked for the year. But they gave me an incredible price. And so for 4 nights, you got your own boat, and it's a nice boat. They're 20-foot Thunder Jets, covered, comfortable, and you get up in the morning and go wherever you want to go. Come back in for a hot lunch and go back out again. And if you want to take a guided trip and you want to go on a guide boat, no problem. I don't know why you'd need to, but you might want to do that for a couple of days, just so you don't have to bait your own hook. But anyway, 1875, I think that's what the price is. And that's July 12th to the 16th. And that's fully included. I mean, it's all-inclusive, except your drinks and your license. Pretty much that's it. And you just fly right into Ketchikan from Seattle. They pick you up, take you there, and it's just an easy, easy thing. And you keep saying you're going to go, but you haven't fully committed yet. I want to see your airline ticket. Anyway, but then we've been talking to Jason Grupp, who has Breakwater Tours, and we're talking about his trip to Belize. Sounds fantastic. And Lake El Salto in Mexico. Ah, man, these places are, it's you know, from what you say, I mean, it's an angler's paradise, Jason.
Yeah, both of those places are. I've got one of the best freshwater trips in the world, and one of the, you know, in my opinion, one of the best saltwater trips you can go on. Mm-hmm. Fishing the flats of Belize for snook, trophy tarpon, big permit. Last time I was there, I got a 29-pound permit on fly, big crab pattern. Took me 35 minutes to land it.
Wow.
Yeah, doesn't get much better.
Yeah. And now, of course, we have Tony that wants you to come up to the Aleutian Islands in Alaska. And let's tell us again really about this, the lodge and the accommodations. Tony, you still
well,
there?
Yeah. Actually, yeah, the lodge and the accommodations. It's a building. I keep it rustic. I keep it kind of like a high-grade and very comfortable fishing camp. I don't try to become too ostentatious, because a lot of lodges in Alaska are, but that keeps the price down. It's fairly expensive to operate up there. One point I wanted to make is that the Lagnac River is a true, you know, one of those wild and scenic rivers. It's one that has never been polluted. I mean, just beautiful river, no pollution whatsoever. I always kind of say to myself, this is going to be the last place in the world you're going to find wild salmon. Because they're there.
Yeah.
That's what we have in the wild.
And wild trout. I mean, there's no hatchery trout up there.
There's no hatchery on the anywhere in Bristol Bay.
Yeah.
So all those fish are native. And that's a big deal. And I think what we offer is wilderness lodges. You know, true fishing in the wilderness, usually you have to hike up. It's not all that comfortable. A lot of us are a little bit older now. I'm 76, you know. I don't want to hike in anymore. And this offers true wilderness experience in comfort.
Yeah.
You know?
We like that.
That's a good deal.
We like that, yeah. All righty.
I like that. I like offering that.
Yeah. And, Frank, we're going to have to get out in a minute. Do you have any comments on anything?
Yeah, if you've never been to the Lagnac Lodge, I 100% guarantee you'll have the best fun of your life.
Well, you know, it's that time of the year, and you got to start planning for next year. So we've given you three or four incredible choices. We'd like to join me at in Ketchikan, or with Jason on either in Belize or El Salto. And, of course, you got to put Lagnac Lodge on your list also. So the problem is yours. Try and maybe you can make all of them. Who knows?
Yeah, that is a good bucket list.
There you go. Okay.
For our season.
There you go. All right, we got to go. Tony, thank you very much for coming in. Jason, I really appreciate you actually being in studio. That's awesome.
Great to be here.
All right. So you're listening to Fish Hunt Talk. Go to fishtalkradio.com and listen to the show as many times as you want. It'll be up probably in a few days.